So I'm happy to give the floor to our special guest, President Alvarado of Costa Rica, to speak more about his proposal. Hermano, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, Dr. Tidrus, mi hermano, my brother. Thank you very much. I would also like to thank President Piñera from Chile that's joining us, and also President Moreno of Ecuador, who was the first one to support this initiative we launched months ago. What's the initiative about? I want to deep dive a little bit on it. We want to create, and we propose to create, a global pool, a repository of intellectual property. And this is with data, with knowledge, technologies, designs regarding COVID-19. And in this repository, the idea is to make available for everybody around the world the different advancements or innovations, to put those into service at the lowest cost, without any barriers to protect people. That's the idea behind this. We are also calling for this to be a repository created on a voluntary basis, because now we need solidarity. And that's what this is all about. 2 months ago, when we launched this initiative, there were many things we were not acquainted. We didn't know about COVID-19. And throughout those 2 months, there's so much knowledge and science created that it's been put to benefit of people around the world. For one case, yesterday I was in one university in Costa Rica in which they took some open source designs for medical devices, and actually they improved those to, with the knowledge locally developed on the treatment on COVID-19, they improved those. And now that university is putting the improved designs also available around the world. Those are the kind of things that we can do now based on solidarity and understanding that this pandemic attacks the same a rich country than a poor country, than a mid-income country, regardless, or even in citizens, regardless whether you have the resources or not, it attacks people all around the world in the same way. So the basic idea is a call for solidarity and a call to action for creating this repository, a global pool for rights on data, knowledge, technologies to make more affordable and accessible the new techniques, new technologies, new vaccines, new treatments, so we can, as one around the world, defeat COVID-19. And the call is for member states or WHO. The call is also for the academia around the world. It's also for the private sector and companies, for research institutions, and for cooperation agencies all around the world on a voluntary basis. We want to see those innovations and technologies as global public goods. Global public goods to protect humanity against this threat. So it's a call for solidarity. As you mentioned, Dr. Tidrus, this is going to be a part of the discussion in the WHO conference next week. And we will be launching this call to action on May 29th of this month. May 29th, we'll be looking for the official launch. We're still open in this initiative to receive the support of more countries, and that's why we're so thankful for the leadership of President Piñera supporting this joint effort, which I appreciate a lot. And going back to this is only together, only with multilateralism, only with that kind of leadership, we can defeat coronavirus. Not closing in nationalisms, not being selfish. It's the time for the contrary. It's the time for solidarity. It's the time to work together. Actually, it's an opportunity for humanity to show the best of what we are made of. And I think it's a great opportunity for humanity to show our brotherhood as a whole. And that's what it's all about, this call to action that we, with also the leadership of Dr. Tedros, we are presenting today. And to you, Dr. Tedros, also to President Piñera and other partners, thank you for your leadership, particularly Dr. Tedros, my brother, mi hermano. We have to keep on with this joint work together. And thank you very much for all what you've been doing. And thank you for supporting as well this initiative from Costa Rica.
Muchas, muchas gracias, hermano. Thank you so much, President Alvarado, for that very, very inspiring speech. I have seen your commitment when we met in Geneva, and also the follow-up discussions we had, especially based on this initiative that you have just proposed. So all my respect and appreciation for your commitment and leadership. And I would like to quote you. Using this initiative, you said, let's show the best of humanity. And I fully agree. And I join you in adding my voice to that call and look forward to May 19 when we launch it officially. And many countries are already showing their commitment. And I know May 19 will be a successful launching event. Muchas gracias for your leadership.